With the debut of ArcGIS Pro in 2015, Esri introduced a new licensing model called Named User. This licensing model is conceptually different from the traditional single-use and concurrent-use models, in that named user licenses are managed through an ArcGIS online organization account or a portal for ArcGIS organization. This video demonstrates the most popular method for managing ArcGIS Pro licenses, that is, using the default named user model with an ArcGIS online account. To manage your ArcGIS Pro licenses through your ArcGIS online organization, we first need to make sure that the organization is activated. When you purchase ArcGIS or start a trial, the person who requested a subscription should have received an email like this with an activation link from the ArcGIS online accounts team. The subscription must be activated by the person who will administer the ArcGIS online organization. If necessary, have the email forwarded to the appropriate person. Click the activation link in the email and follow the steps to activate the account. For this demonstration, I've already activated my ArcGIS online account. If your account has not been activated and you're not able to find the activation email, go to the Need Your ArcGIS Online Activation Code section on this page to request a new activation link. Here's what it looks like. Once the account is activated, in a web browser, go to arcgis.com and sign in with the username for your organization account. Here I'll sign in with the user that I created when I activated the account. After signing in, check that the URL has redirected to your organization. It will change from arcgis.com to the short name of your org, .maps.arcgis.com. Users who need ArcGIS Pro licenses will first need to be a member of your ArcGIS online organization. To invite or add members to the organization, you either need to be an administrator or you need the invite privilege added to your role by an administrator. If you're the one who activated the organization account, you'll automatically be an administrator and will be able to invite and add members and assign ArcGIS Pro licenses. Click on the Organization tab at the top of the page if it isn't already selected. Now click Invite Members. The Add or Invite Members wizard gives you three options. In this example, we'll choose to add members without sending invitations. With this option, you set up the username and password for each member. You must inform the member of their username and password as they will not receive any notification. ArcGIS Pro requires that members have a Level 2 license, so make sure to choose Level 2 in this step. The wizard allows you to add multiple members one at a time or from a CSV file. In this example, we'll add a new member. Again, making sure that they're a Level 2 member. Once we've reviewed the information, we'll go ahead and click the Add Members button and return to the organization. Here, we'll be able to see the new member added. Back on the Organization tab, we see the member that we added to the organization along with their username, level, and role. Again, before trying to assign an ArcGIS Pro license to this user, we need to make sure that they are a Level 2 member. Now that we have members in the organization, we're ready to assign these users ArcGIS Pro licenses. From the Organization tab, click Manage Licenses. To manage licenses, you either need to be an administrator or you need the Manage Licenses privilege added to your role by an administrator. If you do not see the Manage Licenses tab, double-check your role and privileges. ArcGIS Pro licenses can be managed from this page. You can assign licenses individually by clicking the Configure Licenses link under the Licensed For column, or you can assign licenses to multiple users at the same time by adding them to the selected members list. I've added these two users to the selected members list, and now I'll click the Configure button. Depending on the desktop licenses your organization has purchased, you may see any combination of basic, standard, or advanced ArcGIS Pro licenses. You may also see different extensions than what is shown here, or you may not see any extensions, again, depending on what your organization has purchased. Check the appropriate license level and any extensions that you want to assign to these two selected members and click the Assign button. We see that the licenses for the two selected members have been successfully configured. And under the Licensed For column, we see that the update has been made. These users can now open ArcGIS Pro by signing in with their ArcGIS online username and password. Let's take a quick look at how that works. Because named user is the default licensing model for ArcGIS Pro, the first time the application is launched, the ArcGIS sign-in dialog prompts the user to sign in. Enter the username and password for one of the members who was assigned a license in the previous step. In this example, since the administrator added the member directly to the organization and chose the password, when the user signs in for the first time, whether to ArcGIS Online or ArcGIS Pro, they are prompted to change their password. This is a standard security measure to ensure that no other user, including the organization's administrator, has access to the user's password. Upon changing the password, ArcGIS Pro can open with the user connected to their ArcGIS online organization, and they can begin working on a project. For more details about setting up ArcGIS Pro named user licenses, as well as authorizing ArcGIS Pro with single-use and concurrent-use licenses, troubleshooting guidance, and additional resources, please see the ArcGIS Pro Quick Start Guide at the link below. Thanks for watching!